When schools pivoted to virtual learning early in the pandemic, the National School Lunch Program was thrown into chaos. Millions of children rely on school meals to keep hunger at bay, so school nutrition directors scrambled to adopt new, creative ways to distribute food to families. Some of these changes were improvements on the status quo, they say. And as part of pandemic relief legislation, the Federal Food and Nutrition Services Agency waived the requirement that schools serve meals in a group setting, increased school year reimbursement rates to summer levels for school food programs, and granted more flexibility in how food is prepared, and schools started preparing bag lunches and other grab-and-go options for parents to pick up at school and take home for their kids, and even used buses to bring meals, sometimes days' worth, to pick up spots in different neighborhoods. We were able to give whole heads of broccoli and whole heads of seed. The economy of scale from bulk buying these ingredients was a win. We could give much better food, she says. Even though kids are back in school, Martin says many of her pandemic innovations are worth keeping. But the waivers that gave her that flexibility, and a boost in federal funds, are set to expire at the end of June. Health policy experts say the flexibility has served children well. When you improve the ability for the country to deliver food to children, to families, you improve the health outcomes of Americans, says physician Ezekiel Emanuel, co-director of the Healthcare Transformation Institute at the University of Pennsylvania. The pandemic shone a spotlight on the links between poor nutrition and chronic illnesses such as diabetes and obesity, as well as the risk of serious illness from COVID-19, so Emanuel says initiatives that make child nutrition programs more efficient should continue. Martin says the expiration of the waivers and increased funding is going to be a disaster for my program. For instance, with the summer coming up, and a return to the rules that require kids to be served meals in group settings, much of her budget will be used on transportation costs instead of heat. She describes the effect on her program as catastrophic. Bus drivers are in short supply around the country, gas prices have spiked, and inflation has led to higher food prices.